So you might be asking, what are differential equations really good for? And so let's look at a fairly simple example. They're really good whenever we have information about how a function is changing, because that's what the derivative tells us. So imagine that we know that a population is currently 3,000 and is growing by 6% each year, and we're going to assume a continuous growth rate here. Now, you may already know how to solve this from previous courses, but we're going to take a look at this from a differential equation perspective. So imagine that y of t, or let's go ahead and define y of t to be the population after t years. And what we're really interested in here is, what do we know about how y is changing? So what do we know about dy dt? So let's think about the units on dy dt. Y is the population, presumably measured in, let's say, people. And t is being measured in years. So dy dt would have a unit of people per year. So we might look at our problem and say, okay, so how is the number of people changing each year? Well, it's changing by 6%. So 6%, 0.06 per year, but 6% of what, right? 6% of whatever the population currently is. So if the population is very small, we get a small growth. If the population is very large, we get a large growth. So 0.06 times y, the current population. And this is in people, this is per year, and so we're getting people per year here out of this differential equation, or out of the right side. Now, we're also told that the population is currently 3,000, and that gives us an initial condition of y of 0 equals 3,000. Now, you might be able to guess what the solution to this differential equation is, based on your knowledge of exponential growth. You might have guessed that the solution is going to be c e to the 0.6t. We can certainly verify that that's a solution. And then we can use our initial condition to solve for c and find that y equals 3,000 e to the 0.06t, which is the same thing that we would expect out of an exponential type of growth. Now, in this case, using a differential equation didn't really help us that much, except that writing the equation was very simple. So where differential equations become really powerful is where we have more information that is otherwise hard to take into account. So suppose now the population is currently 3,000 and is growing by 6% per year, and 400 people per year are moving to the city, or town, I guess it's more of a town. Anyway, and 400 people per year are immigrating into the area. Now, in terms of exponential equations, it's not really clear how to take that into account. But with the differential equation, remember that this has units of people per year. This is a rate of change. So how does this affect our rate of change? The number of people per year is that we change by. We're changing now in two ways. We're changing by however much the population grows due to the percent population growth, but we also have an additional increase of the population. It is increasing by 400 people per year. And notice that this already has the correct units of people per year, so we do not need to multiply this by t or anything like that. Okay, this is already people per year. And so in the differential equation, we can very simply take into account this additional information. And that's one of the powers of differential equations.